Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to make a melody in FL Studio from scratch using the new features called FL Studio's Chord Generator. So let's hop straight into it. So there are four layers to melody. There's the harmony layer, which is like chords. There's the top line, which is like your vocal melody or your like highest frequency melody. There's a contrast part to your melody, which is usually a lower part to your melody. And then there's a rhythm part to your melody. So we're going to combine all four of those to create a melody. Firstly, let's go to our channel rec. And you will get the project files for free. Just go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Look at the top of the webpage where it says free downloads and just sign up and log in. You'll have access. So let's right click and replace this with Flex. Inside of Flex, we have different pianos we could use. So let's go to the free tab. Make sure you download the Essentials Pianos and all the Essential Packs. Then let's go to Essential Pianos and let's go to Steinway D. Okay, so this is your typical grand piano type sound. Let's turn off reverb, turn off any effects like limiters. Okay, so now we have a pretty basic sound. All right, so let's right click now. Let's go to our channel rack, which is this icon here. Right click, go to piano roll. So now we have a new shortcut. It's Alt P. I'm in the FL Studio 21.3 beta. You have to get this beta from their actual forums. I'll leave a link below. Hopefully I don't forget. But long story short, click the tools icon and go to generate chord progression or hit Alt P. Okay, now from here we can like set up the chords. So it's still a little convoluted on how to go about this, but you're going to right click this tab, go to edit, and make sure you're right clicking for this to work. So let's say we want to create a chord progression in C sharp and then natural minor, which is right here, minor natural. Okay, so I like to keep it on more of the conventional side. The adventurous side pulls out chords that I would just not use. So I like to keep it on conventional. Some of my settings, let me make sure my head's not in the way. I can't see myself. So if you click on the drop down for generate, let's move this slider over to the R&B side. And let's turn up this value for just a little bit. That moves this knob up here, this fader up here. Okay, slider, goodness. Okay, so make sure you turn this on. Replace basic chords with the alterations or add them as extra notes. Okay, so I believe up means on. It's a little quirky because it doesn't tell you what is on and what's off, but let's turn that on. And what else do we need to do? I think that's about it. And just turn this diatonic notes value up. Okay, so now we're going to hit generate and it's going to create a chord progression. Now you can hit play. So I'm like this third chord, so we can click the drop down and switch out this chord. So just switch the chord. It's a little dark for me. Let's switch that last chord. There we go. That has just enough tension for it. Let's hit accept. So now we can work with this layer as our harmony layer. Make sure you go to your piano roll, click the drop down, and go to view. Make sure your ghost channels are on. Okay, this is important because we're going to go to our channel rack, right click and clone this, hitting C. So now we have two pianos. I'm going to send these to different mixer channels though. Highlight these, hit control L. That will send them to the mixer on different channels. So now when we right click the second piano and go to piano roll, we'll see these grayed out notes. These are called ghost channels. So it allows us to see the other notes from the other instruments so that we could play around with those. Okay, so I'm going to play this. In the meantime, we're going to save this. And let's save this as piano melody. And let's create a folder. I like to save projects on my hard drive. What's today? I like to title it by the date, 24. And then give it a subfolder. Okay, that's just a nice way to stay organized. We're going to save that. So you guys will get the project files for free. Once I'm done, I'll save this as a zip. Loop package. Okay, so now that we have that, we're going to grab the top note here and we're going to pull this up an octave. This is a great place to start when it comes to your top line. So we have the harmony layer, which is the harmony. We also have a contrast layer because it added a bass layer underneath. So if this is the contrast, meaning it has to be contrasting, it can be contrasting in frequency, it can be contrasting in the how many times we play the note. So if this is playing slow, another one would play fast. So that's how we're going to contrast the top line from that lower. Also, make sure snap to scale is off. Let's turn the metronome on. So my ear is guiding me through these notes. Ooh, that was filth. That last one. Okay, so now what we're going to do is add some filler notes. So once your brain tells you which notes you want to move to, now we're going to add in some filler notes. There's a formula to this. You could use perfect fifths, perfect fourths. We're going to use perfect fifths first, which are seven semitones from the notes. So just count up seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. I count them right here. And then my ear wants to hear another note. So I'm playing tresillo, which is ta, 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 ta. Ta, ta, ta. You hear that in Latin music. You hear it in drill beats. Okay, so tresillo is very common. So we're using that tresillo pattern. It's not triplets. It's not ta, 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 ta. It's ta, 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 ta. So that's what the melody's doing. We also call that the rule of three or thirds. Now, there's a reason why these notes work. I wasn't thinking in music theory as I was making these. I was just listening to what my brain was telling me, which is a technique that we don't tend to use as much anymore. So here, this reason this works, if you map this out, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's a perfect fourth. But remember, we started with a perfect fifth. So it's a perfect fifth down and a perfect fourth up in this case. And then G sharp to E is, let's count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's an augmented. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's just a major third away. Now, if you really break this part down, it's G, B, D, which is the G major chord. A lot of people skip over harmony and they wonder why their melodies don't have a cohesion. Harmony just says which notes are cohesive. You could spread them apart to create melody. So this is a chord right here. GBD is a major chord. And then we're playing the major chord over, forgot this chord here that we picked. I would have to revoice this. So that's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So that's a minor chord. We're playing a major chord over a minor chord. Just spread out over time. Okay, so again, remember, we're in double time. So if you count it out, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. So if your melodies feel like they're looping, it's probably because they're too short. So in reality, you know, without double time, that's really a two-bar melody. There aren't that many two-bar melodies in the world. I can't say for a fact how many there are or aren't, but if your melodies feel stuck, it's probably because you think you're producing four bars, but in reality, it's four bars or two bars. So let's go back to the chord generator and keep extending this. We're going to clone this to a new pattern. We're going to clone our pattern here, go to clone. And now we're going to use the Alt P. Okay, so what we can do up top is change this count to 8. Okay, so let's make an 8-bar chord progression. So I like the chords up until the C sharp here. It just didn't feel right. So let's switch that out for a different chord. That was a little too happy. These are a little tense. Let's, instead of switching it to a suspended chord, let's switch that to a basic chord. I think because it starts on suspended chord, you have very little options. And then F sharp. This one's a little too bright, so let's pull that to a different chord. There we go. Now last chord's a little too bright, switch it out. So you don't even need to know what these chords mean. We're just switching it out and listening, does it feel right or wrong? Click this drop down to switch it out. Listen for the last chord. Now what I'll do manually is just hit shift down to transpose this. Okay. So I like the chord progression. Let's see if the melody can keep going with that same pattern. Let's copy it over, hit shift. So here it doesn't work the same way because we swapped out that chord. So I want to get down. Better, but it could be a little bit better with the chords. I'm just not going to waste time trying to pick the perfect chord right there. So let's say that we like that. Let's add that to the pattern playlist. And at this point, you're just going to add your effects. Okay, so let's print it to audio. Let's right-click, consolidate from track start. Cut remainder. Make sure no effects are on. Now we have it as audio. Let's double-click. Let's go to mode, stretch mode, and then switch it back to resample mode. So now when we change our tempo, we get different vibes. Now that one note, that dun dun, could be changed. And go ding ding. Okay, so now you can hear those notes that kind of are jarring. So I would go back and fix those notes. Let's just go back to show you what I would do. Now it just sounds perfect in this key, but once we start switching keys, it sounds weird. Like right there, that dun dun. Let's switch that out. Okay, so now that's the power of switching keys. Now you can hear what stands out. Like right here. Right here, something, I think it's the chord. So now you can see with the harmony, the melody has to move around the same way the harmony is moving around. This is why without harmony, your melody doesn't have a context. When you give your melody context, it has to flow with the context. The ending could be better. I'll let you guys finish it because I could sit here for 20 minutes to try to figure that out. It'd be a waste of time. Okay, but that's how you build your melodies. Now, what you could do is then print it to audio. Let's print this to audio. Consolidate track from track start. And let's double click, go to mode, stretch mode, switch it back to resample. Hit control L to send this to the mixer and then start adding your effects. I like the kilohertz effects. Pretty sure these are free from what I remember. So I like the reverser. I like the bit crush. I like their formant filter and their pitch shifter. Add the bit crush. Just adds like a playful tone to the sound. And then I use their pitch shifter to add grains. Okay, so grain size here. And then you could also change the key. turn the reverse down a little bit. So again, those last two chords could be way better. Okay, and then double click to experiment in reverse. Now this has a lot of notes, so playing in reverse won't make it sound better. Just at least try it. All right, so again, at this point, it's just effects and then going back to refine your melody. That is how you do it. Go to BusyWorksBeats.com, download these project files for free. Just go to BusyWorksBeats.com, and at the top it says free downloads. Log in, and then you'll get access to your free downloads. See you guys on the other side. Peace.